Mudjlid, which is the capital of South Kordofan. It's about a 16-hour car journey.
The air conditioning is actually blowing sparks. The mechanism for the air conditioning. So no air conditioning, it still smells of smoke. It smells horrible in here. No air conditioning. We're literally not even out of the Khartoum city limits.
About 11 o'clock in the morning, and we've already covered about 492 miles, nearly 500 miles. We're in North Kordofan state, which is the state that borders Darfur on one side and the east of the Nile states that are close to Khartoum. We're heading to South Kordofan, which is where we're staying the night. That's where the Arab Misaria tribe are based. That's where they start their migration. We're in one of the really typical Sudanese rest stops. We call them gahwas, coffee shops, making tea and coffee. And if you need to spend the night, this is where you spend the night. They just leave them open for travellers at night and during the day. And during the day, ladies like this ply their trade and they sell tea with milk. Ready? We've made amazing time.
We have just sighted the Kordofan Mountains, which kind of run through the two Kordofan states in the west of Sudan.
And why the window is open?
Because our air conditioning started giving off sparks within about 5 minutes of getting into the car. But it's cool. It's quite nice. It's just after the rains. So, I mean, for this part of Sudan, this is actually quite green. Normally it's savanna and the bushes are completely stripped bare.
Which is actually one of the largest cities in the whole of Sudan. It's a major transport hub, both for aid flights as well as for cargo and commercial flights. And it's halfway to where we're going this evening. It's halfway to Mudjlid. We've done nearly 500 kilometers, about 490 something, and we've got another 500 left to go. We're hoping that we'll make Mudjlid before nightfall, but we might get in a little bit after.
So this is basically 500 kilometers of dirt track.
No, it's going to get better and then it's going to get worse. So it's probably about 300 kilometers of dirt track and then another 400 kilometers of dirt track after that, after we pass on Mudjlid. We're now about 5 hours from Mudjlid, and South Kordofan State is where most of the major oil infrastructure in Sudan is. It's also just the issue of the land dispute between north and south over whether it's the Arab Misaria or the southern Dengelok who really have the right to Abyei, which is the area that we're heading to. So it's really, really, really tense here. We've just been told that if there is anything that we aren't allowed to do, it's film. Before we get into trouble for broadcasting the fact that we are filming, even though we've been told we're not allowed to film, we do actually have permission from the central authorities in Khartoum to film and to travel to southern Côte d'Ivoire and Abyei. So this is more about security authorities in the area